All right, hey guys, CVAC0. I'm casting another RD2L Season 3 game. This is EST Monday. It's Tier 1 players versus Hungry Huskars. This is Game 2. Game 1 went in favor of Tier 1 players. They played excellently. Hungry Huskars went for a gank-heavy lineup, but it just didn't pan out well for them. Once again, I am having some major technical difficulties. I ended up leaving my mic at home. So maybe I might have to go back and go pick it up soon. I'm using one of my older mics. This is my first mic ever. It was a headset mic. This is the mic I used when I first started casting. So I didn't know jack shit about anything. But as you can tell, I'm relatively frustrated about that. I do have a backup mic that my girlfriend will be bringing to me. So I will be able to continue casting. So because I'm using an older mic, I apologize for the bad quality. I apologize for the terrible background audio fizzing noises in the back. I can hear it in my own recordings, and it kind of bugs me now that I'm using like a more high-quality mic in my main cast. But it's time for me to cast Tier 1 players. They ban out the Lich and Death Prophet. That's all right for them. I guess they know that Hungry Huskars might like the Death Prophet. I don't know. Hungry Huskars ban out the Clockwork. Yes, the Clockwork had an excellent time against the Doombringer. That was probably about the only thing that went wrong. Hungry Huskars are the one that had the Clockwork. Never mind that. That's my mistake. So, two bans. I'm not too sure. I wasn't paying attention to the draft last time because I was trying to fix a lot of these difficulties. Chris Maiden is the first pickup for Tier 1 player. It's almost like the reverse here. Hungry Huskars picked up Chris Maiden last time. But I guess Chris Maiden is just that safe support that they feel like they can pick up. Bristleback is the pickup here. Most likely going to be offlane, but he can look to be a tri-lane hero. And he's pretty strong in the tri-lane. He can take out Ancients. You stack Ancients in. The Quill Spray will damage and kill him. And they do activate the Bristleback ability on this hero. Rubick is a follow-up here. He's a very safe pick. And already, just a Chris Maiden provides so many spells that he can steal. Anything he steals from her is excellent. If he steals Freezing Field, it might be a bit dangerous because you have to stand in the middle of the team fight to throw it down. And it's very mana-intensive. Rubick usually struggles a bit on having mana. Bristleback as well will struggle. Normally, I like seeing a Bristleback-CM combination because the aura is very nice for him. But there's going to be a Bane pickup. I wouldn't be surprised if I see maybe a Morana. I know RD2L likes to run a bit of these cheesy strategies in general. You know, to get the arrow and you get to sleep, get the arrow, and then maybe finish it off with a Frostbite if you need to. Or you can go Frostbite Nightmare into an arrow. It might be whatever way you want to set it up. We can look for Crystal Maiden to jungle a bit as well as she can. Just go to a hard camp, Frostbite, a creep for 10 seconds. It takes so much damage at level 1. It's almost even overpowered in my opinion. Although okay, maybe not overpowered because you sacrifice a lot of lane control. That's why you pick up these supports, for lane control. Although Bane does just scale very well in the mid-game and late-game. Thanks to the Fiend's Grip that goes through BKB, get that lockdown, get a bit of pure damage from the Brain Sap. And of course the Nightmare. A lot of pro teams lately have just been leaving Nightmare at level 1. It's barely... The duration's only 4 seconds. I say only, but that's a damn long time. Teams can juggle it, and they do get an immunity for the first 1 second, I believe. Hungry Huskars, what their bans to go? They ban out the Morana. Okay, so I guess they are afraid of that cheesy strat. They ban out the Lifestealer, and Lifestealer would be excellent here as well. Doombringer gets the ban out. I guess they just felt like Doom was just so tanky, doing so well. Even though Doom had a terrible start early on, but that's just the nature of the matchup. Nature's Prophet gets banned out. Maybe they just don't want to deal with the rat. Klinks is still in the pool. If there's going to be a rat, that'll like and throw. Maybe even a carry Naga Siren. Just play a little bit of that esports Titan style. Alchemist is the pickup here. He's so versatile. I mean, you can play him support, you can play him out carry, you can play him mid. Probably not offlane. Just doesn't do well. but with the third pickup for Tier 1 player, they need to pick up one of their cores now. They have two supports already. We might even see a Bane mid. I really, really, really doubt that, but for whatever reason, people might run Bane mid. You know, last time I casted, I think one of the teams ran a Bane mid, and he did an excellent job. Got level 6 and just ganked the crap out of every single lane. I give him some mobility, like a blink or 4 staff, and it might just be over. Before you know it, putting people in that internal sleep, possibly. Well, Gyrocopter is a pickup here. This is not a bad combination at all. Sleep, of course, and you get the Frostbite into a Rocket Barrage. That level 1 spell, Rocket Barrage, just deals so much damage. Look at that. Look at it. It's just ridiculous how much damage you can deal early on with that spell. He can win tri-lanes almost single-handedly if he gets a one-on-one situation. And of course, he does add a bit of teamfight. I like the synergy that Tier 1 players have so far. Hunger Huskars, their synergy is not immediate there. Their damage seems to be over time. You do have the Acid Spray, you do have the Quill Spray. That will be nice for them. They do have a lot of meat in the front so far, but Alchemist needs time to tank up Bristleback as well. They need their levels, they need their farm. Bristleback probably going to look to get that Vanguard up early. Alchemist, if he goes mid, probably might get a mech or Shadowblade and just go ganking. There's a Venomancer pickup. They really just want to spread that poison and that AIDS and that damage over time. But Hungry Huskard needs to make sure they're tanky enough for that. Now you have the Gale, you have the Poison Nova, you have the Acid Spray, you have the Viscous Nasal Goo. It's a lot of green stuff. Even Rubick is green. This is almost like a green and yellow lineup. This is pretty funny. They can even look to get Viper. Or they can get Dragonite and just leave him at level 1 Dragon. And just use level 1 Poison Dragon. Whatever. Maybe this is a theme. But they do need a mid. Unless Alchemist goes mid. Viper fits okay here. I think DK is slightly better. I think DK is actually the better choice here. Gives them the meat that they need. He lanes well. And, you know, if he gets a Shadowblade, there's so much ganking opportunities here. And Bane will have to grip one of them. And Dragon Tail is a long-range stun, so you can get the Bane when he grips. And, oh, speaking of that, Rubick is great at sealing Bane spells. Viper is the pickup here. And so, maybe it might be a deny pick. It really might be a deny pick. But this leaves Hungry Huskars. They have to think about this now. They can either throw this lane away, because Viper just almost outlanes every single mid in the game. It's so hard to win against a Viper mid. He's just one of the better laners in the game. Or they can just try to survive the levels. DK, his lane's just going to suck. He's not. If DK lanes against a Viper, if they pick a DK, I'm assuming a ton of stuff. But viable mids here. I don't think TA is that great. Yeah, TA will have a very hard time. Razor isn't too terrible. Steal all the damage from the Viper. This is a Storm ban. It's very interesting. I see very little synergy with the Storm. I guess he can just create space. Timbersaw also gets banned. They themselves could have picked up Timbersaw. Yeah, Timbersaw would have been nice for Hungry Huskars. He can get early levels in Reactive Farm. And I mean, same with DK, he can get early levels in Dragon Blood. That's why I think DK is an excellent pick here. He just needs to farm just a little bit, and he does add that push that you need, damage over time later on. For Tier 1 player, they need their offlane hero. There's plenty of choices there. Windrunner is a very classic and safe offlane hero that you can go almost... With that 6.79 patch, Fucking Mad was talking about it. He's saying that you can almost pick any range hero and just go offlane. Even Ice was like, he wanted to run like a Ancient Apparition offlane. He thought that might be alright. And, you know, he might be right. He really might be right. So Tier 1 player. What else? I wish I had like that hero pull map where I can just click on a button and see what other heroes are left, because it's hard trying to think of all like 120 heroes. I can't remember how many are out right now. Elder Titan. Yeah, Elder Titan has been completely ignored here. Elder Titan, he's alright here. He does add a bit of counter push. with the spirit into a stomp, and especially if you have like meaty tankies up front. And well, yeah, he could do pretty well. You get the Elder Titan spirit. You can with the nature order, natural order, deal a lot of that damage. And yes, there's a Razor pickup here. Luckily, that's one of the heroes I was talking about, like a super surprise. He doesn't lean fair that badly against Viper. He can steal all the damage in Viper, can only try to get some DPS out from the poison attacks, and that might be it. I think Razor, in terms of last hitting, Viper's base damage isn't that great. I think Razor, if he gets static link first, should dominate the lane. I guess it really depends on the positioning of Viper that Viper gets. If he can get tons of poison and stacks on him, this lane should be a wash. For a tier 1 player, they just need an offlane hero, Windrunner, Elder Titans, what else is there? Invulgar. Well. So this throws a huge wrench in the plans. I can't even tell you what's... Wow, this is just... I'm shocked. I don't know how they're going to land this. Is this going to be 2-1-2? If it's not a 2-1-2, I don't know how they're going to land it. Okay, here's a possibility. CM jungle, Bane, Gyro, safe lane? I can't tell you. I'm shocked. I'll have to see how they do this. It might just be pub style 2-1-2. I'm not going to even try to guess far. So HHH, they're going to run safe lane, tri-lane. Safe lane, tri-lane. So Alchemist is going to be the farmer there. Razor will be mid. Matching up against Invulgar. And I think Razor should win this one pretty easily. Of course, Cold Snap's going to be a pain in the butt, but the Static Link should just make life hell for him. Zebra Cakes might look for the Arteezy spot in a little bit. That's right there. In case you guys don't know, Arteezy spot's really nice. It helps you get that set up for a nice mid lane block. And if he gets a nice mid lane block, Invoker's just never going to have a good time. Spider Sam. Yep. Okay, so Viper's going to get the solo against the Bristleback, so they're going to run the Aggro Tribe. Okay. Alright, so maybe I could have guessed these lanes. I guess I just had a mind block. I was really shocked. I guess I was so set on seeing Viper mid. And I thought they were going to go with a conventional offlane, like ET or Windrunner. But they're going to go for a first one. First blood, here we go. Rubick. Oh, there's a Gale on three heroes. This is looking really bad. Crystal Maiden might die here. There's a sleep. We'll get the stun off on the Wom. It's a triple man stun. This is looking really bad. The Wom. Oh, nice body block. Do they have enough what it takes? Rainmaker's taking a ton of damage. So CM takes the haste from. We'll run away with that. Rubick doesn't have his lift. He will have it in 1 second. There we go. We'll get a double man stun. Here we go. I think. Jab is dead. No, they're gonna try to concentrate on Jab. They actually throw him back. What? This coordination. What? This is looking really good for the Radiant, but plays from the Gyro. Keep the CM alive. And she grabs a haste room. And the Rubick picks him up and throws him backwards. Was he just trying to stun the Bane and maybe get really greedy with that, or just trying to dodge the rocket barrage? But the one trying to ward here, but he will die. Nice sleep, actually. Kreger's gonna go down. We'll get the trade on the one. They need more kills, that they're gonna try to offset that. Instead, Rainmaker is the one that's in trouble. There's another rocket barrage. No, never mind. No mana. Trying to tango up. I think he's gonna get out just fine. Bane getting really greedy. There is a pause though. Viper, is he lagging? I don't know, but there's an insane amount of action going on. Still, both sides going to have to burn through a ton of region. Alchemist is low. There's still a salve up on 420 enabled, but it's time for me to introduce the players while there is a tactical pause, or puppy pause, or just server issue pause. Arbo Herbal is playing Rubick. He needs to redeem himself. He had an absolutely horrid game as the CM that last time around. Dr. Kreger on the Venomancer, Bristleback on Jurgen Klinsmann, currently the U.S. soccer head coach. Alchemist being played by Rainmaker, and Razor being played by Zebra Kicks. On the other side, TOP, or Tier 1 player, Salacity, I can't tell you. It's on a Viper. CM being played by the Wom. Gyrocopter is being played by Kayak, 420 enabled. Bane being played by Jab. Volker being played by Spider-Salmon. Here we go. There's going to be a go. It's going to be resuming. I don't think Jab's going to be able to kill... Oh, actually, he's got a lot of base movement speed onto Rainmaker. He might have been able to go for that. I don't think it would have been a kill. You still have to... Well, I mean, Alchemist does have zero armor, but this out-shield proc could have happened, and then it would have been really bad for Jab. Would have been really bad for Jab, yeah. So now they're going to have to burn through a lot of regen. Arbor Herbal... Maybe Venomancer brought a self. Does he have a self? No, he doesn't have a self. This will not look too good for them. But as we saw, the Rocket Barrage dealt so much damage. Just really, really too much. It's almost too much. But Venomancer, Dr. Cracker, looking to get another three-man Gale. That was an excellent opportunity right here to get like a tri-lane wipe. They could just figure out who to concentrate. So they're just going to try to survive through this. It's time for me to move to last hits and denies. I've been kind of neglecting that. Viper leading all. That's not surprising. He should have an easy time against this Bristleback. Bristleback needs his levels before he can be really effective. Well, is there engagement? I felt like there was. Razor against the Invoker. Yes, this is what we expect. The Zebra Cake should be dominating that early enough. And already getting pulled a bunch of tangos. They're going to sleep this Venomancer. He does get the D-Ward off. Will they be able to go? Needs to be very careful. Could look to turn this around. I think they should. He's taking a lot of damage. It might be a bit too late. He's going to throw him backwards. There's a stun going out. Alchemist is just hiding. He needs to get it out somewhere. He's going to take a ton of damage. No, he's just going to stay there. Oh, he disconnected. That's probably why. That's a pretty big deal. I think it would have been a kill if he's able to get it off, especially with an isolated gyrocopter like that. And Bane is out of mana, too. He's way out of mana. So, a ton of issues. Alchemist will reconnect, but the damage is already done. He's already taken a ton of... loses a ton of health because of the failed unstable concoction. And there's a go. There is a ready. Here we go. After the second pause, we're back in it in this tri-lane. Dishing a lot. There's some... Oh, no, that's just me pinging. Lulz. Job probably looking to get a lucky nice little clarity for him. I think she should use a clarity on him because Bane spells are so expensive. If we look at the last hits, Gyrocopter 6-0, Alchemist 5-0. Alchemist might just have to try to spam the acid spray to keep the lane or just for zoning purposes. It's the only way he's going to get last hits. Gyrocopter. Did he? Yeah, he went for a level in stats. That's interesting. Rather going for a flat cannon, he goes for a level in stats. Again, that could also be a misclick. And Volker got that Null Tusman trying to last hit, and Spider-Sam, actually, is he going to dive? No way. No way he's going to dive that. He does have a DD rune. Wow. Oh, if he turns on that DD, that would be a ton of damage. It's going to hurt a lot. Rubik, I think he wants another go. Wants another go. Oh no, Rubik's gonna get slept, I think. Oh, homing missile on him. He just needs to sleep. Doesn't have the mana. We'll get the mana now. He probably should have popped it earlier. Sunstrike is there. Herbal's dead for sure. Gale on three. They do get a nice one, but it's too late. Concoction does hit three as well. And, well, I mean, Herbal goes down. Once again, is he gonna feed? Because, I don't know. It's a hard game so far for him. It's only level two. Zebra Grace will find a haste rune. This might be time. Hasted. DD rune. So scary. He can just... Oh, I think he can kill him. Just kill him. Just needs the right setup. Is he just going to go for it? I think he needs to clear the creep wave. That's his best chance. Clear the creep wave. No point in denying it. I think if he clears the creep wave, he can get a kill. Or he can just go bot and just wreck everybody's faces. I think he should. He needs to salvage this tri-lane. Yes, there he goes. He's leaving the lane. They do have the ward going, but there's a sleep. Rainmaker might be in trouble. He needs to throw the concoction. He's getting chain stunned. He's going to go down. They do blow up 420. He's going to get the return kill for sure. Zebra Cakes is there. He's looking to clean up. We'll kill one. We'll kill two. We'll kill three. This is going to be a triple kill. I think, oh, even pops the ulti for this. Jab is so dead, and now suddenly they break even 4-4. Great rotation from Zebra Cakes. Great rotation. Haste rune, and the DD wore off, but it didn't matter. Trilane salvaged. I mean, Trilane is salvaged. Razor could look to snowball from this, and he needs to snowball, otherwise he's just not going to have a good time. They're losing... What? Wow, Viper. Viper is now losing the lane. It might be because of the Bristleback finally using his Quill Spray. And with the Quill Spray, you can zone out Viper. Viper has low HP pool. And now you have two levels in Bristleback, you should be fine. But once they gather up, the Razor and Bristleback combination is very scary. And it does kind of add to that overtime, damage over time situation. And the more dewarding action, get that 50 gold. Wow, Rubick finally hits level 5 somehow. And if Venomancer is only level... Was that what? Did I see that right? Rubick's level 5. Wow. Venomancer's only level 2. Oh no. Oh no. This is looking bad. There's going to be a sleep. I've seen this combo before. So has Rainmaker. He's going to go down for sure. Oh, they actually sleep him first. I'm not sure why, but it doesn't matter. Rainmaker will die here. There's a last, you know, a Gale that probably shouldn't have been thrown. Because now you have no mana. You can't do anything. At least Dr. Krager will get some HP. Oh gosh, no. Arbol's going to go down for sure here. Getting caught out like that. I'm not sure why this Alchemist was so far forward without the Rubick around. It might be time for them to just like rotate the Trilane to somewhere else. This Trilane's just not tuned well. You just need a Razor constantly to babysit you guys. Otherwise, it's just going to get ugly. Well, Acid Spray is there. They're looking to zone out some more. We'll get a bit of last hits. He's not level 6 yet, so he's not nearly as survivable as 4 Razor. It does have a TP scroll, so it can look to go in at any moment. He will have to push out the lane for that to happen, though. Crystal Maiden looking for initiation. Wow, she's really far forward. But that's just how confident this Dire team is. CM5, Gyro5, Bane5. I mean, we saw Venomancer. He was like 2, but now it's 3. 4, 5. There's a big discrepancy in terms of farm and levels. Oh wow, yeah, 3 levels and Crystal Nova just wants that AOE damage. But Bristleback, I mean, he's leading all. I'm super surprised on how he's leading all in this situation. Viper is just harassing. Actually, he wants to go on a kill on Jurgen Klansman. Razor actually kills the Invoker, but Invoker gets the trade. But Jurgen Klansman will die. Celacity will get the kill. Good kill for him. This is what I was expecting. Celacity should have been able to kill him earlier. I guess he just wanted to chip him down slow and easy. Slow and easy. Razor did get the kill on Invoker, but Invoker did end a killing streak, so maybe it might be worth it. I don't think it's worth it, actually. Never mind. Because the EXP was wasted there. Rubick gets initiated on, nearly dies. Oh no, nice sleep from Jab, I was about to say. But might get to deny, no, they do get the kill, but they lose the Venomancer. Rubick is trying to do what he can, but there's another Rocket Barrage here. Call down is available. They want to go. They're going to try to go on the Bane. We'll throw it out. They really want to go on. The Zuber Kicks is there. Jab is dead. Razor leaves him for death. Nothing of value was lost. Is what he's thinking. He even steals the Regen Rune. Nice for him. Razor's actually going to go for Mech early on. I think that's the right choice if they want to get back into this game and continue and try to protect his Alchemist. That was a pretty big kill. I mean, they do kill 2 supports there. They lost the Venomancer once again. Venomancer. Was it? Yeah, I think they lost the Venomancer. But good plays for Nabane. I mean, he made the CM last a lot longer. although Zebra Kicks was there. Good rotations for him so far, and this is exactly what they needed. Some more pinging. I think they know. Yeah, they know the supports are there. They're just going to try to deward once again. Dewarding action. Tons and tons of it. You might have to start getting really crafty on how you ward. One option for the Dire is they can ward here. Does block the camp. They could just like throw one aggressively right here. They can throw one up here. Whatever they want to do, they can even just put one right here. Maybe just get creative. But Gyrocopter stopped, they really want... Oh, they do kill the Bristleback. Glad I caught that at the very end of it, at least. Zebrakicks wants to chase down two heroes. I don't know if this is the right choice. This is really scary. Ooh, I think I'm going to... Oh, I apologize for that. Oh, that sneeze. So they do get the kill on the Bristol back, and they probably could have turned it around on a Razor, but I guess they were scared about where the other two supports were. They could not see the Venomancer, they could not see the Rubick, and they didn't want to turn it around. Rubick hasn't made too much progression in terms of EXP, right? I think both the supports need to just sap some EXP somewhere. Maybe sit mid just a little bit. Or try to get the kill on Spider-Sam. Spider-Sam doesn't see him, gets lifted up. He does have Illusion Rune, but it won't matter for him because Zebra Cakes will find him. Sunstrike is there. Zebra Cakes taking a ton of damage. Will they be able to kill him? Spider-Sam has no more right clicks. He's so sad right now. Rubick is now level 6. Never mind about sapping EXP. Just get kills, right? But they need more than that. Dr. Krieger is wrapping around on jab. Oh my god, Vel gets missed. Oh man, nice stutter step there. They do get a double stun, but oh, Alchemist is gripped up, gets a full stun on there, and wow, I'm lagging like crazy. They do get two kills here. Nice rotation. Huge miss from the Venomancer, and it's just absolutely hilarious. He just basically stutter steps and make them look foolish. Almost like that Philip Rivers when he was trying to block downfield. it was pretty funny. So still, I mean, Alchemist, well, he's level 6 at least, but he's not going for the farming Alchemist, he's just going for better Alchemist, but that's just how rough his game has been. Rubick has Stolen Brain Sap. That's actually a nice spell for him. Still, it's like 200 mana cost. Jeez! What? Like, that's so heavy on him. He's only got 300. He can't even cast a combination right now. Razor just walks right past the supports right here. Oh, I'm surprised they didn't get revealed. They're going to try to go on mid, but little did they know that the Razor was there. Both sides are trying to gank. They're really looking for somebody. Gyrocopter, I think, is feeling it. Yeah, he's feeling it. He knows. He backs up. Now the two supports, I think they know. Do they know? They need to back up, too. Back up the other way. No, they're not going to go. And there's four heroes there. This is going to be really bad for the Dire side right now. Rainmaker is there. We'll get the stun off on top jab. Jab will die. The Wurm also. Wow, the poison stink from the ward there. Yes, it will be dishing out. The Wurm will die. I guess they were expecting some more rotations from the backside and try to pincer them, but that's all five heroes from the Radiant, and they're going to look to push the tower now. No matter what's stopping them. Still, I mean, because it's early game, early-ish game, then the supports will be back. Yes, they're back already. Oh, that's already Arcane Boots for him. Are they just going to give up the tower? It looks like they're just going to give up the tower. The supports already have TP'd away. And Volker, he went Midas first, so he's just trying to get levels, trying to get farm. Not really caring about battling right now. They're willing to give up a couple of tier 1 towers for this. They're just going to try to make it painful, create some space. And I see Gyrocopter and Volker already pressuring the tier 1 towers top and mid. So that's good-ish trade for them. Bristleback trying to tank up the damage already. The Wurm? Oh, he might get caught out. We'll get the stun, but there's going to be a sleep grip soon to be coming. Oh, wow. Alchemist takes a ton of damage. They're going to take this tier 1, I think. There's even the Razor ulti there to zone them out. Rainmaker gets gripped. Oh, no, he's going to go down here. This will not be worth the trade if he dies. Yes, we'll die. Zebra Cake's trying to do something. He gets slept up here. Gale misses once again. Solacity. He needs to pop the mech from the Viper. Is popped. Bristleback is there trying to kill Solacity. Actually, does he miss the Nasal Go? Yeah, I think he missed it. But they lose two heroes. That's completely not worth it. They take the tier 1, lose two heroes, and they nearly lose their tier 1 towers. Yes, they're going to lose top. Easily. Yeah, they lose the tier 1 tower on top. Not worth it at all for this Radiant side. Hungry Huskars. Not having a good time. A bit of miscommunications. Wasn't sure Alchemist is going to go in or not. That was like a 3v5 situation too, so well done. Well done from tier 1 players, rather. Made the right decision. Continued being a pesk. And oh, need to be careful. I think Garbo, they need to get that rune! Yes! He's going to die regardless. Oh, did he lift him? Yeah, if he had lifted him, there's a chance he would have survived. Lifted him backwards. No, I don't think it would have survived. He needed to grab the Hastern instantly. Tier 1 tower mid will fall as well. Razor making it a little bit difficult, but there's no way they're going to stop that. Try to get denied, but in the end, not quick enough. Razor? Razor gets spotted by the wards from the Venomancer. Arkham is trying to farm up something. Still no levels and gold right now. Trying to get some zoning out. Looking like he's going to go for Armlet just for that Battle Alchemist, but why not? They're just falling so far behind. Ascents and Denies, all of, three of the top heroes are of the dire side. Time for moving net worth. And yes, it's saying much of the same thing. The Razor had a great start, but that's about the only bright side. Bristleback actually was doing all right, but he's 0-2-0. That means very little impact. Like, zero impact, basically. Yeah, EXP is well in favor of the Dire. So is gold. And it's very similar to last game. It looked like there was signs of life from HHH, but I think it's just going to quickly get out of control. Invoker will now get involved in fights. He's almost got his Ag Scepter. Watch him just invoke like a madman and possibly go ice DPS style, although he actually goes for Yules rather than Agams. The reasoning for not going to Agams early on is that your mana pool can't support it. Because of that, I don't know if I agree with going for Agams this early. There's a chance he can go Scotty. There is a small chance he can go Scotty, and that's not bad at all. Just more slow, more DPS, more survivability. But I think he's going to go Agams. I think Yules would have been the better choice here. You get the movement speed, you get the initiation. Maybe like Yules 4 staff and then get a bunch of Forge Spirits. He does have four spirits up. It is double Forge Spirits at this point. Looking to push, he could look to just harass the Razor. No. Zebra Cakes is still very scary though. And there goes my phone, I apologize. Let me throw that to the back of the room. Bane is going for 4 staff, I believe. Unless it's a Yules. He could go Yules. I don't think that'd be terrible. And now they're just going to starve. They're going to starve the opposition. Like, Alchemist just can't do anything. He's getting his EXP sapped because the supports are just trying to protect him. Viper. Incoming Viper. He's going for Ag Scepter as well. Unless he's going Scotty. The bomb. Just spending a lot of time just running back and forth needs to either A, stack a camp, or TP somewhere, or maybe try to set up a gank. But I think they know they're ahead, just going to take their time, building more of a lead. They do have a gyro, so stacking camps will be very beneficial. CM is a bit under-leveled, almost only level 8. I guess that's okay, though their cores are doing excellently. Midas on Invoker for about 10 minutes, maybe not 10 minutes quite, but 8 minutes. We'll finish with his eggs. So I'll go ahead and take a peek at the graph. There has kind of been a lull, and it has actually favored. It's kind of just stabilized. And if it's stabilized, then it favors the team that's behind. That means you're at least somehow keeping up the farm and you're not being starved. Bristleback will push top just a tidbit, but he's scared. Finish up his tread, so he's a bit more tanky. Possibly looking triple TP scrolls. And the Dire Heroes are grouped up. They're killing Illusions. Okay. It's gonna kill Illusions. So they know there's 5 heroes mid. Bristleback's gonna pressure their tier 1 tower at least. Maybe hopefully grab a TP back. He could look to go in, but the Dire team, they're pushing mid themselves. Acid Spray will get dropped here. Yes, just to try to slow down the push, it definitely will. And tier tower gets taken. So there needs to be a trade from the Dire. They need to do something, otherwise this will be a bad one. But they're gonna fight. They're really gonna do this. There's something stolen. It's just a Viper Strike. Well, that's actually pretty good. Yeah, Viper Strike is the ultimate. Yeah, that's pretty damn good. But I like this ward. This is probably one of my favorite ward spots in the game. I see so much behind this tower. I drew a penis. Well, might as well finish it, right? Yep, finished it. Finished. Nailed it! Okay. And Invoker. Gotta use his Midas. Yeah, Midas is it. 2,700 gold, jeez. Sentry is out, do they know that? Well, the Sentry almost catches this ward. But Venomancer is constantly scouting with his Venomancer ward. I really like that Plague ward, so good. And he's just gonna be a huge pain in the butt and trying to slow down the push. It's only level 2, so he's gonna wish it's a bit more. Because they're just that underlevel. Oh, jeez. Job gets called out, but it might be a big calldown's gonna hit 4 heroes. That's so much. They're gonna take them all out. Oh, they only kill the Bane, but it's well worth it. It was a huge bait. Bristleback is there trying to kill them. They do get the Gyro. Will get the Invoker. Yes, they do kill the Invoker. This is a decent trade. Okay. Alright, but Bristleback will die. Solacity might be in trouble now. Rainmaker trying to dish out the deeps, but he's got no deeps. Look at that. No deeps at all. Gets slowed to oblivion, and he's gonna get caught. He's gonna die for sure. And yes, there we go. Gets picked off. Just so slow, so slow. That was a team wipe, I think. Venomancer does come back. He's still level 6. Rubick level 6. Since the two support sides so early, they get no EXP for that. They get none whatsoever. So team fight one for the Dire, for sure. So Viper, because he survives that, will get a ton of gold and EXP. Level 15. Let's compare that to the Venomancer. Level 6. He's so sad. The Battle of the Aids goes in favor of this Flying Snake Man. Flying Snake Man. So, Gyrocopter. The cooldown was just excellent. I mean, they all just swarmed to him in that small little choke point. Right here, and the cooldown was just perfect on that AoE, just absolutely perfect, and we saw them just melt. Nothing they could do. And the Radiant just gonna fall further behind. They just need to try to catch up. Luckily, Alchemist is one of the best catch-up heroes in the game. Just give him some stacks. He'll have his Greaves greed there. Just all for him. All for him. But he probably needs to go BKB, so his damage is still not going to be good at all. He does have at least level 2 Chemical Rage, so I mean, move speed better, base attack speed better, but is it enough? Bristleback was able to do something. He was tanky enough. He's going to go for drums. Just tank up, give him more attack speed. He is the highest level on his team. Actually, no. Yeah, he is. Razor was pretty close. Is there going to be another engagement mid? I think they're confident that they can win it. Well, the Dire, that is, are confident that they can win it. They still have a bit of everything. Oh, Rainmaker. Jeez, oh, that's just unfortunate for him. He dies again. But the Radiant, they really want to fight this. I don't know about this. Krieger will go down. Oh, this is a choke point. Excellent for Invoker. Where's the Meteor? I'm waiting for the Meatball. Where's the Meatball? They kill him. They don't need the Meatball. Razor's in the backside. They do kill the Bane, but it's not enough. Meatball is finally dropped. Spider-Sam will kill Bristleback. He's in a bit of trouble. We'll get slow. We'll kill Spider. We'll kill the CM. A triple kill. More than a triple kill. Double kill for the zebra cakes. Doing well for himself. Indeed, he's going for the eggs. Level 14. Nice having that AoE to pick off invisible Invoker like that. Solacity. He could actually turn things around if he wants to fight. Look. He can fight them. Actually, no. Razor would just steal all his damage. Illusion did a debuff him. He's stealing all the damage. There's a kill, yes. There you go. Venomancer goes down. He's just so low level, just not having the time of his life. Is he really going to go for mech? What? No, I guess he's going to go for pipe. Might be miscommunication. If he's going to go for pipe, he needs to pick up the Veil of Discord. Not the Veil, cloak. Yeah, cloak. Planeswalker's cloak if he wants to survive. Whoo-wee. So, looking at that, who won that trade there? I mean, it's saying that the Dire won it, for sure, I guess, especially if the Venomancer are dying for it a second time in a row. And how many times is that? 1-7 and 12. That's not what you want to see on your supports. 1-5 and 10. It's just been really hard for these guys. Definitely very hard for these guys. Bristleback with the drums of Vanguard has tanked up considerably. CM needs to be careful. Not sure what she's doing there. Oh no, because Viper is there. Rubick is the one that might be dead. Rubick is trying to lift him. Armor will dodge the Sunstrike at least. But the CM is there. They're really going to try to turn this around. This is looking really bad. It's a 3v5 fight. There's a grip on the Bristleback, though. Bristleback has turned his back, and there is a pause while they're ganking. Is there a DC? Razor will need to rotate. If they want a chance to try to salvage this, they might just abandon it. Volker is not there, but he did throw the Sunstrike. That's all he got. Volk is still there. He actually has a ton of mana. Jogcopter taking out Stacks. He's pretty low. He's pretty low. Yeah, DC on Eraser. Alright, well, I don't think they can burst him down quite yet, but he's going to be slowed really heavily. The Gale's already used. Poison Ivy is coming off in 14 seconds, but it won't be enough. I don't expect them to be able to save the Bristleback. He is tanky, though. He's going to need a lot of... He's going to need to block everything, basically. And even then, I don't think it's going to be enough. I predict he's going to make it here, and then right here, and then he's going to die. Just right here, he's going to die. Razor is going to get about right here, realize that they can't do anything, or he can try to wrap around here. Realize he can't do anything, try to back out and get caught out or something. And maybe kill one or two of the swords. Alchemist is just going to continue running. I don't think he's going to TP. He's going to like clean up, run back, heal up, and throw an acid spray, try to protect this tier 2 tower. Gyrocopter is going to heal up after that. Volker... No, he's not going to TP in. He's just going to continue to take this tier 1 tower. Gyrocopter might rotate in for that as well, because there is a salve on the Volker, so he could look to salve up the Gyrocopter. That's my prediction. Power outage. He's restarting his computer right now. Oh boy, it's going to be a while. So I'm going to take a drink of water while I'm at it. Water's so good. Water's so good. So, I mean, 4HHH, Hungry Huskars, how do they get back into this game? They can't take fights like that. They probably should have disengaged as soon as they saw it. Sacrifice the Rubik and just leave. They saw there was three heroes there, they only had like two or three with them. Venomancer was in the back. He did throw the Gale. Did it hit anybody? Did hit the CM. It hit two heroes. So they are pretty slow. CM, I think she might drop her ulti for this one. It's well worth it to drop your ulti. Drop your ulti. Kill the Bristleback, and there's no way the Dire can or the Radiant can fight this. They'll take the tier 2. They just need to try to keep their vision up on the map. Stack the camps. This Alchemist needs to get back into the game. He needs a BKB. The armlet. It's helpful, but it's not enough. Really not enough. Gyrocopter, he does have his BKP, 2100 gold. Interested to see what he picks up. It's most likely going to be a damage item. He could look to save a butterfly. Butterfly is just a safe... It gives you everything! Jeez. Butterfly is like the best item for an agility hero. Gives you damage, gives you armor, gives you evasion. What else do you need? Really? I guess you need HP. But he could look to build this into a Satanic, and then who needs HP? And then this gyro is quickly getting scary, and yes, there's a reconnection. I was expecting it to take like 10 minutes or so. So lucky me. We'll see if my predictions came true. I expected Bristleback to die around here. If not even earlier, Brazier's going to try to rotate around here, realize he can't save him, it's going to try to back out. And even might get picked off. He could go here. Could go here. I actually call that Razor moves here. First, yeah, I think Razor's gonna move there, and then just back out, and all go. We're just waiting for a confirmation from the Radiant side, from the Razor, and Zebra Cake has just been doing everything he can, but here we go, and CM ulti, yes, there is, they use the CM ulti, that's a lot of damage, actually, he will kill the CM, actually, and he does die right here. Godlike streak for the Viper Salacity. Something bad is happening in your... Gyro actually is just gonna back out. He actually goes for the. He's gonna go for the MKP. Just wants the damage, not really for the evasion or anything else. And why not? I mean, he can do it. He can definitely do it. Surprisingly, Bristleback was able to dish out a ton of damage, killing the CM and nearly killing the Viper. I mean, not Viper. Well, he did do a lot of damage to Viper, but you're killing the Bane. But they're not going to pressure to tier 2, I'm interested. Well, I guess that's probably because Invoker and Gyrocopter were just too far away. They're going to try to pick up this Razor. Razor might die. Dr. Krigan will definitely be in trouble. There is a slow from Salacity. He did pop his ulti for that. Tornado. Meatball gets dropped. Probably should have waited a little bit before that. Combination wasn't quite there. We'll get to sleep on Krager. Krager looks to be dead. Gets cold snapped. And cut one more. See, I'm not going to KS that quite yet. Something stolen from the Rubik. Like, yeah. He stole Freezing Field. That's a good spell. Not that it'll matter, because I don't think he'll get it off for more than like a second. Or even half a second if he gets lucky. I think he'll just get bursted. But it is a nice spell. He could maybe we can see some pro Rubik plays where he just hides in one of these trees and the team's like, "Where is Rubik?" while like just panicking under a freezing field. It's always awesome when you see a CM do that. It really is. But Bristleback is back, so let's see if he'll be able to hold on to this. Rubik looking for some way to initiate, just trying to get some wards out. Arbor, really, really daring right here. Could get picked off easily. But no, the Dire are just going to back up. Viper is not there in a fight. He's the one that holds the mech, so yeah, it's a pretty big deal. And Viper, wow, finished his eggs. Got the Yasha, looking to get the Mantis doll. His damage is just insane at this point. He's on a godlike streak, too, so if he does die, it's a pretty big deal. Tier 1 tower will get siege. This is pretty dangerous. Really short tornado. Meatball combination. We've seen this. Oh, Rainmaker. He's so sad. Crystal Maiden ulti. But that's sort of Rubik. There we go. Cauldron's going to hit four heroes once again. Bristleback is there to do the 2-for-2 trade. 2-for-3 trade. Oh my gosh. The damage from the Viper is so much. Sunstrike is there. Bristleback just isn't survivable enough. He just can't do it. He just can't do it. He's trying to man up. It's just impossible. It's a team wipe. It's a 5-for-2 trade. Yeah. They really got greedy, wanted to take the tier 1 tower, just wasn't enough. Team wipe, and it's just ugly. I'm not sure why they forced the fight there. They can't have won that. I guess they just wanted the tier 1 in the back. Thought they can take it quickly, expected. I guess they saw the Viper top and didn't think he'd get there, get back in time that quickly. Whew, so Invoker, he's got 5,000 gold basically in the bank. He could just go for mobility. He can go for a Hexic. If he gets Hexic, I don't see any way that the HHH can come back from this. They Hex up the Bristleback and they can kill him. He doesn't have to spam his Quill Spray at all. And he's just getting kited. That's a huge problem with the Bristleback. You get kited so heavily. Oh, Rubik, I think he's dead. Invoker's here. Right clicks. There we go. We've seen that before. You gotta be really careful when you're Rubik. You just can't do that. Cannot do that. Invoker gets the kill on the Rubik. He's 6-4 and 11. He's actually died quite a bit. But I guess that's why he might even go for H, but I don't think so. So Gyrocopter, he has been dying. He did die in that last fight, but he's still well on his way to his MKB. A little bit slow. But when you run a tricore like this, that are just greedy for farm, it's hard to find it sometimes. Roshan will be attempted. Salacity. Looking like he could even solo this thing. But Roshan, I don't think the Radiant can contest this. It'll be very difficult. They're going to try, though. Looks like it. Do they even know? I don't think they know, because Bristleback is not bought. They're just going to give up this free Roshan. Not of their choice. Gyrocopter will get it, and there will be no problem. It does. He just comes back. As long as he saves up his flak, he'll even have to call down. Call down hit so many heroes that last fight. Even though he died before then, the call down just did so much. It really did. The Radiant heroes keep swarming just one. And when you run this many melee heroes, or this many heroes on the front line, with the Razor, the Alchemist, and the Bristleback. Yeah, that's just gonna happen. The Razor had a good start, but in the end, it's not gonna be enough. Nice smoke. They're gonna find someone. They're gonna look for someone in the jungle. They're actually gonna try to cut mid. I don't know. Well, sorry about that. I don't know if I like this smoke. They're gonna try it. They don't have any. I don't know if they say anything. Via horrible T gets called out once again. You just gotta be careful about that. You gotta really be careful about that. You gotta know that there's something was up. Top lane was pushed out. Nobody had TP'd in. So you know there's something going on in your jungle. Even then, that was probably not the right place to ward. If you're going to try to ward that, it's safer to go through here. Then you can wrap around here and then get a ward up. Would have survived. Maybe would have survived. Razor trying to get some harass out. There's still one man down, but Rubick will be up very soon. Bristleback wants to go back in. Does he really want to die this jab? He's in position for an amazing grip that will be so hard to cancel. Once he get, they're gonna go. I think they're gonna grip him. Yes, they do grip him. At least Poison Nova gets thrown out, but I think they're gonna kill the Bristleback before anything happens. They do get the Bane. He is the first casualty. Crystal Maiden dies as well. Caldon is gonna hit 3-2 heroes. Alchemist is in the middle of it. Caldon gets stolen from the Rubick. Nice steal. Aegis gets popped. Solacity is also in trouble, and they're just gonna try to back out on this one. EMP gets dropped as well. Razor action still going on. Well, Rubick does die from the homing missile. And Volker nearly dies. Viper is just dishing out the deeps. And they're just gonna steal all his damage, trying to keep him alive. Nice still. Zebra Cakes trying to man up. It's not gonna work for him. Dragonman Cleansman is here, and he's trying to kill him. Maybe Tornado is there. There is a ton of levels and a homing missile. Homing missile is, it does hit. Is he gonna steal this? I don't think so. Cold Snap was there. A decent fight for the Radiant. It wasn't absolutely terrible. I think Bristleback, yeah, he bought back on that one, so maybe not the best situation. He's going for BKB. He's got exactly zero gold. That means he just barely had enough gold at the time to buy back. Well worth it? Yeah? I mean, you keep... guess Malcolm still died. But they do hold the tier 2 tower. They do stop the push. Gyrocopter, they're farming the stacks just a bit. Oh, there we go, MKB up there. The damage is pretty high. Pretty high, 100 plus 165 for each flak pellet to hit. Viper, 1600 gold. Well, Crystal Mania actually goes for the Yule Scepter. Maybe HP and Staff might have been better. I'm not sure why people go Yule Scepter over Force Staff on CM, especially in this situation. I guess you want to catch people out, but even, I don't know, I still think Force Staff is just higher utility. Just more versatile. Invoker gets a kill on the Rubick. It's... Man, my friend, this is brutal. It's brutal. Horrible T. He's just getting caught out constantly. Bristleback is there. Are they really going to fight this? They know their Volker's there. They don't have detection, though. Wants to go in? Maybe? Really wants to just snipe someone. Spider Sam does find Dr. Krieger. Will he be able to blow him? I don't know. Venomancer pings him out. There's three heroes there. Still no detection whatsoever. They're going to wish that Rubick was there. He does have that sentry. And tower holds again. That is a Rubick going top. Is he going to get called out? He steals flak. That's funny. He steals flak. What's he going to do with flak cannon? Really doesn't do damage with that. They're going to try to make a go, but there is a BKB up on the gyro. He could just BKB up and run away. Boots of Travel and Volker. Here we go. He's whoa, mobile as crap. There's a tornado. There's a fusel. Is there going to be more? Sleep on a Bristleback. Oh, Rubick dies as well. Zebra Cakes will almost kill the CM. I think CM will go down anyways. Bristleback gets gripped up. He is there. Oh, Calldown is as well. But there's so many heroes already really low for Zebra Cakes will finally die. Will not get out on this. We'll try to kill on Volker. We'll get the kill on Volker. Buy back from Volker. There's Poison Nova as there. Sunstrike will not hit. Nice dodge for them. Bane will die. A gyrocopter is there to dish out the deeps. He does pick him off. Alchemist trying to do whatever they can. Yes, they do kill the gyrocopter. And Vulgar even bought back. Is this a comeback? Guys, is this a comeback? I mean, look at that graph. It's over. It's 25k in favor. EXP in favor of TOP. 14k gold in favor of TOP. But we're going to watch that graph spike. Maybe just a tidbit. Did anybody buy back for that one? I don't think. Did Alchemist buy back? No, he didn't buy back at all, Rubik. No, he didn't buy back. Brissback's buyback was on cooldown, so even if he died, it wouldn't have mattered. They can look to just do something now. And Volker, I mean, he did die, but he won't be able to do anything with this gold. He actually finishes the BKB. That's a pretty big deal. The Brissback is still dishing a ton of damage out. Brissback trying to get that BKB up. He's tired of that magical nonsense and getting locked down and kited. But sooner or later, Bristleback's going to scale off. Gyrocopter's BKB down to 7 seconds. He needs just HP a bit more. It's a bit more HP. He actually goes Invis. Confused. What for? What do? Viper. He's got 3,000 gold in the bank. Not sure what. He's 15-0-10. Holy moly. If they kill him, they'll get so much gold. They'll get like 1,500 gold, basically. But there's a steal, but Rubik's going to die. Rubik, once again, gets called out. There's a Gel. But I need to ask him. Why is he always so far in the middle of everything? I think Rubik is 113-11. Wow. It's not a score you want to see. As a support, your goal is to make less than like 1/4 of the deaths on your team. Bristleback doesn't have any gold. He's unable to really farm that much. His buyback will be off cooldown in 30 seconds, but he doesn't even have the gold to buy back. He might need more, but they're going to grip Rainmaker. His BKB was popped. This is a lot of trouble. AC is almost done for him. He really wants to. Actually, he's going to get away just fine. Hey, they canceled that TP. Are they really going to go? Yes, they canceled the TP. That's a smart choice. It would have been way out of position if they did not cancel that. Razor, I think was TPing at that moment. I wasn't looking at the color icon. It's hard for me to memorize them all. But there we go. They're going to try to start sieging the tower. This is the perfect time. Alchemist's ulti is on cooldown. Acid Spray is being anointed, but Slacity is just going to stand in the front line. He is tanky. He does have the mech up. But Yule Scepter from the CM, I'm not sure. I mean, unnecessary, I guess. But cooldown's shortish. Shortish, kind of. But yeah, they're not going to make it easy. They're going to tank this to the face. Oh, they actually get to deny tier 2 will fall. Are they going to fight this? No. I'm just going to back out. They were just trying to make it as painful as possible. The lanes are kind of in the Radiant favor. It's hard to say. I mean, mid's pushing a tidbit, but a single Acid Spray will solve that. Alchemist still needs to farm a bit more. Trying to look to finish his AC up. Maybe just buyback might be more worth it if you can somehow find it. Roshan will spawn in a minute and 15 seconds or 10-ish seconds. Viper goes top to clear out that annoying little creep wave. In terms of towers, surprisingly, the Dire are just barely ahead in terms of towers. I mean, the gold differential, the EXP differential is huge. Yeah, look at that little blip. That was a teamfight that was won by the Radiant. They still really respect. Right, we need to get that away. They still really respect the damage output that the Bristleback and the Razor can dish out. Razor still needs to survive a little bit more. He's gonna go for a BKB. I don't know. They need to get him, allow him to finish it. They will find an Invoker. Would they be able to kill him? I don't know. They don't have any detection. So when Chris Madden gets called out, I think she'll be the sacrificial lamb. The one will die here. Nope, Meatball is there, but Rubik, it does get piped up. Venomancer finished the pipe. Wow, Dr. Krigan, where did that come from? Where did you get that gold? I'm very impressed. But Poison Sting, such a pain in the butt. Really is. And Volker will get caught up. Meatball again gets popped. BKB is there. Is there body blocks? Is there body blocks? No body blocks? Does body block just a tidbit. But Volker's going to run. He's on the run. There's a sleep going out. They're so scared right now. BKB is ready for the Alchemist. They're just trying to sit around for this Bristleback. Bristleback did finish his BKB. Viper has a heart. Jeez. Wow. He can dish out. He can throw out a lot of Viper Strike. Roshan is up. If they knew, they could possibly go in. No way they can go in, actually. There's too many AoEs. Call down. Got the meatball and everything for the Volker. Viper can finish off any Stranglers. And, of course, Bane's Grip is still there. They don't need the CM to do anything. Another stack will fall to the Gyrocopter. He's going for a Butterfly. I guess need that survivability to get that evasion. Has finished it. Not going to save for buyback. That's okay. They're far enough ahead. They don't exactly need their buybacks. Dr. Krigan does have a smoke. They could look to do something about this. What can they do, though? They actually finally pick up some dust. But Roshan will fall really quickly, I believe. Okay, maybe not that quickly, but quick enough. They do finally ping him, but it's too late. It's way too late to really do anything about it. And there we go. Roshan falls to the Dire, and Bane, wow, picks him up. Bristleback's in a ton of trouble. He needs to TP out. We'll TP out. There's nothing that goes through. Oh, never mind. Just kidding. Bane is there. They're going to be able to get this kill. This is a high quality kill. It's a 10-second BKB. Well, Invoker is taking a lot of damage, but that's okay. Still, Bane will fall. Invoker at least will have to go back and heal with Poison Nova popped. Venomancer did not throw the Poison Nova. Possibly if he threw the Poison Nova, he could have gotten the CM and Invoker kill. Then, and there we go, they're just gonna go down lane, and Alacrity up on a TD Gyrocopter. That is so scary. Butterfly finally finished. He's 5 slotted, nearly 6 slotted if you want to count the Aegis. But all he needs is another damage item, Boots of Travel and Satanic. Okay, that's quite a bit, but 43 minutes in, this is pretty fat Gyrocopter. Radiant's middle tower has fallen. He did die quite a bit. He's level 4 and 2, or in 12. Alchemist, he's not tanky enough. He doesn't have any damage. He needs a damage item to actually stand a chance. If he can get Abyssal up, that would be a pretty big deal. Venomancer, they do have a ton of counter-pushing. They do have the wards. They have Razor, Plasma Fill, Acid Spray, and of course they have Fade Bolt. They even have the Meatball on their side. But Bristleback is still down. I think they can hold it just in time, just enough for Bristleback to come back. And once they do, the Dire might have to back up. Tornado is there. If that catches anything. Oh my gosh, Venomancer gets caught all. He couldn't even get the pipe off. Oh no. Crystal Maiden is there. Razor dishing out a lot. It's taking a lot of damage, but maybe not enough because of the steel. And they do get the stun off. Is it going to be just a one-man stun? That nearly was a two-man stun. We'll kill their Invoker right now. They took a kill on Invoker. Good start already. Venomancer dead. Bristleback is joining the fight. There we go. Here they come. CM will die. The Dire is on the run. Somehow they're on the run. They do have the Aegis. Wow, this Gyrocopter is just not tanky enough. They do kill. Well, did they kill him? I can't tell. Yes, they finally killed the Viper. There we go. Look at that. 1,400 gold for this Alchemist. He's really, really happy about that. And they're going to push the Tier 2 tower. That was such a big... Wow, are they going to make a comeback on this one? Look, it was 30k EXP in favor of the Dire. How it's 20k for gold? Was it just the positioning? I didn't even catch that. I think they just manned down. Gyrocopter maybe just needed more. Bristleback's damage was not two kittens. And Alchemist somehow did it, but I guess the Razor Axe was just there. Viper's damage wasn't as impressive as I thought it was going to be, thanks to Razor's static link. They're going to push Rax. Oh my gosh, they're going to push Rax, and they're 30k down, and they're 20k down? Really? Oh my gosh, they don't have the Viper. They do have a grip, at least. Rainmaker is in a bit of trouble there. Oh my gosh, Bane just melts. But here we go, they're going to take the Rax. First set of Rax goes to the Radiant? What? What am I seeing? This game. I don't understand. I what? Okay, well, I mean, Calldown is there. They can still salvage this. They can. If they wipe, they can win this team fight. Alchemist does have buyback, though. He does have 5,200 gold, but he wants to go ham. There you go. He doesn't have the damage, though. He knows he doesn't have the deeps. But Bristleback is there. They will kill the Gyro. Gyrocopter. No, it's just Aegis. Just kidding. False alarm. CM's trying to run, but she's going to go down. This Yules does absolutely nothing for you. I'm telling you, the 4-step is just much better in this case. Well, I guess he might get away. We'll die to a creep. But the two supports are gone for the Radiant, but that's okay. They get Rax. They just want to back up now, heal up, and then re-engage. And the item choices for the CM, the Gyrocopter are just not paying off now. Gyrocopter needed survivability, like HP. Like, evasion does nothing for you with the Bristleback. Invoker, I guess he needs more survivability. In general, these guys just need more survivability. Viper did survive quite a long time, but his damage, I guess, wasn't enough. It just wasn't enough. Bristleback Razor, magical damage was just insane. Even if I can't even call it magical damage, just the mixed damage was just really good. And the Venomancer got picked off really early on. Really did. So, I mean, Arbol's team, they're back into it. Like, 30k EXP down, 20k gold down, but they've suddenly jumped back up onto this. With that Rax, they can come back from this. Now I can say they're firmly into this game. And I almost want to say they're in a driver's seat. I don't think... I don't know what I can say. It's 50-50 now. Maybe I should just stop looking at the graphs. The graphs really are not saying the true story. The Alchemist is worrisome. He actually goes hard. Doesn't want to go HP. I'm surprised on this. His survivability is enough. What he needs is damage. I really think he should have gone Basher and turned into Abyssal Blade. Okay. I guess they just want to survive then. Just want to hang out just a bit longer. I guess he's gonna just try to rely on his Assault Kira's. But oh, he needs to get out right now. If he gets caught off, this would be huge. He doesn't have buyback. If he dies, he doesn't have buyback. There is a blink grip. Rainmaker, you're in a lot of trouble, my man. He doesn't have his ulti either. They don't have the damage, though. They don't have the damage. He's too tanky. Alchemist is there. Gyrocopter is there. They will kill him, actually. He does get locked down, will die. He gets denied, you know, committed suicide somehow with that. But now this is really bad for them. They don't have the Alchemist. He can't buy back now. But Bristleback is trying to do as much as he can. Poison Nova is there. Their Satanic has not yet been popped. Now it's going to be popped. But they're stealing all the damage from the Gyrocopter. Razor doing so much work. But they can't come back. Alchemist trying to... He wants a buyback. He doesn't even have the gold. And that's what I'm saying. They do get a brain zap. Are they going to be able to hold? They need to hold off for a little bit more. They already used up all their ulties. They don't really have much. What do you steal? He stole Viper Strike. Okay, good. Good, good. That's a start, I guess. But the Radiants, they need to take advantage of this. I mean, the Dire, they need to take advantage of this. And I think here they go. Here they come. They have Mantisol. They can look to just chip away. I guess they're really scared of Zebra Cakes. But Bristleback needs to be careful. If he gets caught out, this would be huge. He doesn't have buyback either. Doesn't really have buyback. And are they really just going to wait for this? Alchemist is almost there. Tornado's not going to catch anybody. For once, Rubick doesn't get called out. Bane, he does have his blink. Will have his grip very soon. Alchemist needs to be careful. He doesn't have buyback. When he comes back, Bristleback as well could be in trouble if he gets gripped. They're really tanky at least. And here they go. They're going to go. Satanic is off cooldown. BKB for the Gyrocopter is down to 5 seconds. Need to be careful on how they use it. Pipe is used. And so they're just going back. I think they should have just manned up and tried to take the tower. There's no way that the Radiant could have defended that, in my opinion. Unless it just completely dived tier 4 towers. And I guess they just had a backup, really wanted to defend. But Roshan is almost up. They just need a little bit more time. We'll get down. So gyrocopter, really going to go for that six slot now. Finished up Satanic. Look for boots of travel. Probably plus one more damage. Will he go divine rapier and try to man mode Havoset, finish it off? Maybe. He does need damage though. It might not be enough. Maybe like go for Daedalus and look for those crits. But oh, they're in now. A Salacity, nice Mantis stop. It's not going to be enough. Meatball is there. There's a line of, it's a decent start. But now the Dire are split off. CM will die. There's a grip, but it's not going to matter for anything. Jap will fall, I believe. Calldown is there. Oh, nice sleep. But Calldown's going to hit four heroes. Gyrocopter trying to man up against these two tanky beefy mofos, and now they're going to go. Calldown is. Flat Cannon and Rocket Barrage is there. Will they be able to do it? Rainmaker is now not in his ulti form. He needs to be careful. He's just going to back up. But man, the deeps from Gyrocopter are still a lot. And Volker's trying to do what he can. Rainmaker might die. Will die. Will die. Will fall. Alchemist falls once again. He does have buyback, though. He does have buyback. Another win for the Dire, but they can't really push it. They lose the fight. Is there going to be Cold Snap? Cold Snap is there, but needs to be careful. Will fall. Yeah, Bristleback will fall. Team wiped. The Radiant gets team wiped. Do they have buyback? They don't have buyback. Alchemist needs to buyback. Now's the time you need to buyback. Push out top lane or mid lane a little bit. Force them to come back. And then TP mid. Or TP back home. That's I think the right choice. Your two supports will come back. Poison level wasn't used in that fight, but Razor, can he buy back? He can't buy back. He's trying to go for the refresh. He's almost got it. It was looking really good for them, but the gyrocopter was, the Satanic was keeping them alive. Yes, there we go. Alchemist finally buys back. They need it. Whoa, Rubik needs to be really careful. They have the tornado. Will it catch him? It does catch him, but he should be too far away to really get called out. But the Mets are trying to deal what he can. But they're going to try to man down the tower. They do have the glyph. Pop the glyph. They pop the glyph. Now they have Razor back. But they are still down with the Bristle back. And there we go. Gale is there. He wants the pop hit. He needs the pop. There we go. Looking to try to get in. Calldown's going to hit four heroes again. Oh my gosh. How often are you guys going to get that? Poison Nova is finally out. They're just going to go bang. They're going to bang on him. Yeah, there's a man fight, but it's not going to be enough because that's a Satanic, guys. That's a Satanic, and they're going to fall. Once again, Rainmaker looks to be dead, and this is looking really bad. He gets gripped. He will fall. There's no buyback. This is GG. I don't expect him to be coming back from this one. Rax will fall. There we go. There's the melee. There's the range. And then maybe even taking a second set right here. Right here. I don't know why the Radiant were so forceful on that. They were the ones behind, but I guess they didn't feel like it because they had the Rax. I guess it ended up looking okay. The Satanic pickup on the gyrocopter was really the backbreaker, finally. And what an amazing game, I have to say. I counted the Radiant out so far a long, long time ago, but they managed to come back. Mostly a bunch of miscues from the Dire. Tier 4s will fall. There might be one last huzzah from the Radiant. It won't be enough. And finally, the Bristleback is scaling off a bit more. And the calldowns have just been like on point. Rubik will die once again. That's just been absolutely on point. Dr. Krager will die as well. Won't even get anything off. Will kill the Invoker, I think. Invoker will die. Oh, no, just kidding. Well, yeah, well, you'll finally die. GG gets called. 2-0 victory for Tier 1 players. And a very impressive victory. They pulled off their laning strats. Conservative strategies. And they get the ganks off. Questionable item decision-makings, I think, for a couple players. But, you know, the end justify the means, right? But anyways, thank you for watching. That was Game 2. I hope you guys enjoyed, and also hope you guys join me next time.